A woman who hit and killed a man on a skateboard had cocaine, marijuana, illegal prescription meds, and several drug smoking pipes in her car.
Police arrested her on drug charges, but haven't charged her in the crash.
Meantime, the family of the 22-year-old from New Smyrna Beach is just distraught.
WESH 2'S Claire Madds is live at yesterday's crash site with the latest on all of these developments. Such a sad story here, Claire.
It really is, Martha. This young man from New Smyrna Beach was here in South Daytona, either carrying his skateboard or on it. And he was either here in the bike lane or on the sidewalk behind me. Witness statements vary. But the driver veered out of the road heading northbound, hitting this young man, killing him instantly.
He would walk into a room and immediately a smile would break out onto your face.
Catherine Wilson is a heartbroken widow at the tender age of 22. The love of her life, the father of daughter Marley, Stephen Wilson, died instantly when a car slammed into him along Ridgewood Avenue in South Daytona. Chopper 2 was over yesterday's scene. And now we've learned the driver who swerved into Wilson, 31-year-old Jody Arcuri, had a pharmacy of illegal drugs in her car, along with crack pipes, though we still don't know if she was under the influence.
I hope that the justice system does what it needs to do, but nothing's going to bring him back. You know, my baby's still going to not have a father anymore.
Arcuri has a long history of driving infractions, including two crashes, one with bodily injury. And she's previously served time for drug possession. Police can't be certain what distracted Arcuri, but the victim's mother says whatever it was, it cut a promising life far too short.
He's going to be missed so bad. He had a wonderful heart. He'd do anything for anyone.
Police arrested Arcuri on the drug charges, then took her to jail under the Baker Act for mental health treatment because Arcuri made statements about hurting herself when she learned Wilson was dead. An accident would be hard enough to accept, say loved ones. They will be devastated if they find out substance abuse was a contributing factor.
There's no need for senseless deaths like this for our young people.
A heartbroken family, no doubt. Now, police in South Daytona got a warrant to take blood from Arcuri yesterday before taking her to the jail under that Baker Act. She was able to make bond, but was immediately transported to a facility that handles mental health issues and substance abuse issues. So she remains there right now. Again, we'll have to wait and see what blood tests show us as to whether or not she was under the influence. We're live in South Daytona, Volusia County, Claire Metz, WESH 2 News.